Not even against migrants. For example, we are full of these horizontal conflicts which have been replaced the vertical conflicts, the good ones. The ones which oppose the poor against the rich, the people without power against the powers, and so on. And the big majority of the victims of this distortion of target is our own people. Most of the poor and popular neighborhood are racist now, and not only in my country. And once they were leftist, and now they are becoming racist and rightist. So people's minds don't move following mathematical rules. I think that there are some elements needed to be a credible point of reference for people. We should have the capability to represent real interest. The real interest, the real spirit of people. But also, and perhaps mainly, the capability to create a sentimental connection with the soul of people. We need to be able to produce cultural hegemony in the whole society, which means the capability to build up broad alliances and what now they are calling win-win coalition with other sectors of the society. And this could be a good period because there are a lot of the small capitalists, for example, which knows very well that they are in the middle of the crisis, like the workers, and perhaps they would like to find some alternatives. But this depends from the capability to have a vision, to have a vision of the future. And this is the problem. This is what, according to my experience, I'm not an intellectual, I'm not a scientist, I'm a social activist. But this is what I feel is missing. And I give you only one example or two. I was very happy when I was told that the European Confederation of Trade Unions and decided to mobilize next 29th of September against the social cuts. And I'm still very happy. Too, I hope we will be able to build up a European mobilization around this date. But why they had to choose as slogan this one? No social cuts, more growth. More growth. Do you think that there is only one worker all over Europe which really trusts that in the next 2-3 years any kind of growth will be possible in Europe? Everybody knows that this is simply a dream and a wrong one. Another example. Many of us in my country, we were really moved looking at the workers queuing in some days ago to vote in the Pomigliano d'Arco Fiat factory. Fiat, no? The big car factory. And they had to vote on a referendum which was imposed by the dictator of Fiat. I don't know if you are informed about it, I will tell briefly the story. Fiat told to these people in this factory, which is in the south of Italy, so a place where work does not exist. Okay, people, we are going to close the factory and thousands of people will be in the street, but not close the factory, and we will come back from Poland to produce again in Italy Panda cars. But you have to forget the right of strike, to forget the right related to illness, the health rights of the workers, which are guaranteed by the constitutional law. And your work time will be decided by us, not regulated in the contract. Well, two out of the three ETUC of the big trade unions, two out of three accepted this diktat and invited the workers to vote yes in the referendum, where they were obliged to choose yes or no. The biggest part and the most popular leaders of the main center-leftist party leadership was supporting the agreement too. Nevertheless, 40% of workers voted no. And even for the metal workers trade union, which was against the diktat, it was a big surprise. 40% in this kind of situation, when all these people were and are really risking their salary tomorrow, not in the next generation, and tomorrow they are risking and they are voting and they vote no. How many could have voted no if all trade unions and all the leftist parties would have supported the no? I think they could have been 90%. 90%, because of these 40% which were and are risking their salary, they had to be two against their own left representative. So this example is only one, but I think that tells us a lot about how big has been and still is the subalternity of many left to the logic of capital nowadays, which seems really to be unbelievable, because now even the capitalists don't trust anymore in their own system. And many of them, I'm sure about it, will be ready to listen to other options. And then, to close this story, I would tell you something which happened personally to me. Yesterday, when I was coming here, I received a call from a friend of mine, which is a leader of the only trade union, the metal worker union, FIOM, which was against this diktat and this very horrible agreement. And he told me, okay, Raffaella, I spent the last 2 years on the roof of the occupied factories, because in this period, the only way to break the silence against the workers' condition is to be on the roof, to sleep in the tents, to make very strange things, because nobody takes care of them. And so he told me, I spent the last 2 years in the occupied factory. I fight with the worker, I live with them, and when we are lucky, we conquer 2 or 3 years of salary. But we know, and I personally know, by sure, that there is no future for what they are producing. There is no future for what they produce with this work. And I know personally, and many of them knows, that to go on producing cars, it's a madness. And so he told me,